Hey, Mavericks fans, this is why you subscribe to Dallas Mavericks Today, because we break down all of the action throughout the NBA offseason. Every single Mavs signing, every rumor, news, item, trade, whatever it is, we're going to break it down throughout NBA free agency. So subscribe. Don't miss any of it. It's youtube.com/MavsTV. If the Mavs sign a player, we're going to talk about it here on Dallas Mavericks Today. So do not miss any of our coverage here on the show. Mavericks Today is presented by Manscaped. Harrison Graham and Chase Sr. with you here on day one of NBA free agency. A couple of more signings have come through the books for the Dallas Mavericks. We'll break it down for the next 7 or 8 minutes or so. An interesting one, Chase. Sterling Brown, 2 years, $6.2 million. Not a flashy name, but a kid Dallas is familiar with during his time at SMU a few years ago.
Yeah, really played well at SMU, doesn't have to go far to Dallas, and 2 years, $6.2 million is a financially smart move to add depth to your roster. Is this guy going to come in and be a superstar player? No, but you're not expecting him to be. You're not paying him like that. It's important when you have superstar players to have a deep roster with a bunch of guys who possess a variety of different skill sets. Sterling Brown kind of has that. He can stretch the floor a little bit. He can score it. He can come off the bench. If you need him to come in and give you a spot start here and there, he can do that as well.
Yeah, and look, he got shipped out to Houston mid-break last year in the P.J. Tucker trade. Shot 42% from three, and I thought him going to Houston was actually great for his career, Chase, because, look, Milwaukee was very deep, right? Like, he wasn't getting consistent minutes there, so he goes to Houston, takes advantage of a situation in which they need guys to eat up minutes, especially after Victor Oladipo got shipped out. 8 points a game, 44.5% from the field, 42.3% from three this last year for Sterling Brown. Not a flashy signing, but he's 6'5". He can play multiple positions. Decent defender as well. I'm trying to compare this for you Mavericks fans. This is like a better Wes Iwundu signing from last year,
nice.
Which that did not work out for Dallas. Not going to give you 30 minutes a night, but 15 to 18 minutes off the bench. He can stretch the floor. He can shoot. He can play some defense. Still a young player. I think overall this is a pretty good signing. A signing that is probably going to be more impactful, even though we don't have the full details yet. Reggie Bullock, Chase, 3-year deal. We don't know the per-year annual value yet there, but that's a guy that played very well for the Knicks last year as a 3-and-D player.
This is a guy last year who was critical for the Knicks' success on both ends of the floor and for the identity of the Dallas Mavericks. This is a hard-nosed player who never lacks confidence. If you give him the ball in a big spot, he's not afraid to let it rip and let it shoot. From the corner three, I think this guy is really good. I mean, from distance last year overall, he shot 41%. But I'm just imagining Luka Doncic maneuvering in and out of defenders, breaking down defenses. And as defenses do collapse, Reggie Bullock is going to be a guy who can camp out around the perimeter as a very good catch-and-shoot player. And I thought his value was on full display last year for the New York Knicks. This guy got steady playoff minutes. He's a pretty good defender. He's got somewhat of a handle, but it's a little bit too loose for my liking. What you really want this guy to do, chuck threes and hit them in an efficient way. And I think that's what lured Nico Harris and Jason Kidd to a player like this, who really increased his value with how well he played last year in the Mecca.
6'6", he can play the 2, the 3, maybe even stretch 4 and some pinch, but probably not super often. But versatile defender, played really well for the Knicks last year. Really the only guy the Knicks has not retained throughout free agency as he lands here with the Dallas Mavericks on a 3-year deal. Don't know, again, the full details on that contract. Better signing, RB for Reggie Bullock, SB for Sterling Brown. Playing a little bit of a guessing game because we don't know the contract details on Bullock. Certainly, I think Bullock will play a bigger role on this team, but I like Dallas adding two good shooters here, Chase.
Bullock is probably going to start, I would imagine, but if he comes off the bench even better, there's no doubt it's RB for Reggie Bullock. He's the better player. He gives you a little bit more value, and I thought last year he was tremendous for New York, and I think that's why the Mavs ended up pursuing him.
And if you're on the fence on which better, which player's a better signing. Bullock's got the better hair, so you have to type RB
elite
for Reggie Bullock. Elite dreads, no doubt about that. Speaking of hair, shave yours off downstairs. Get going with Manscaped at manscaped.com. Promo code Mavs. You can get 20% off plus free shipping with that promo code Mavs at manscaped.com. Keep the dreads upstairs. Keep it clean downstairs. That's what I say with Manscaped because, hey.
Elite job by you.
You're having That's a romantic great. Night. Your girl comes over. You know, things progress. You don't want it to be like the Amazon down there. You want it to be nice and smooth next to your balls. And the Lawnmower 4.0 is going to help you get there without any hair pull, without any razor burn. I tried a bunch of products over the years, Chase, and I almost gave up because I was like, it's just not worth the pain downstairs. Manscaped changed my life because it's advanced skincare technology. You're not going to be feeling razor burn after you get your business done downstairs with Manscaped. And hey, if your girl likes a little bit of hair, maybe a landing strip right there, four adjustable guards with the Lawnmower 4.0. Get going with Manscaped. Manscaped.com. Promo code Mavs to get 20% off. I absolutely nailed that read. All right, let's look at the Mavs' current lineup here, Chase. You mix and match with this lineup, maybe Tim Hardaway Jr. is a flame-throwing sixth man now because Reggie Bullock could start. Maybe Dorian Finney-Smith comes off the bench. Also, what you could do, and we saw this a lot last year, Chase, Finney-Smith plays stretch four, KP plays the five, you bring Kleba off the bench as well, Bullock could slide into that starting five.
Yeah, you just got to hope that Kristaps Porzingis won't be scared to play the five because sometimes I do worry about his toughness. I actually think Reggie Bullock figures in nicely instead of Dorian Finney-Smith. So you bring Dodo off the bench, and then you have a lineup that has a lot of shooters, but also I think increases its defensive mentality a little bit with Bullock. So I kind of like Luka, Hardaway, Bullock, Maxi Kleber as also a stretch big, and then you got Kristaps Porzingis who can also be a stretch big. There are a lot of different options for guys who can space the floor and kind of open up some driving lanes for Luka, and then when he does drive and he does get swarmed, he can find some of these guys around the three-point perimeter.
Good thing you got versatility. You got seven or eight guys that can start. Jalen Brunson can start as well. You've got some depth on this team. Tim Hardaway Jr. kicked things off for free agency with the Mavs. He signed a four-year, $74 million contract. That was pivotal for Dallas to bring back your third leading scorer behind Luka and KP, your second leading playoff scorer because KP was a stiff against the Clippers, and then Boban Marjanovic back on a one-year deal as well. This is really a two-part signing. One, or three-part. One, fan favorite. Two, Luka and him are very close, and you want to keep Luka happy. And three, actually gives you some mismatches offensively against certain lineups. He has some value on certain nights. So to get Boban Marjanovic back on a cheap one-year deal is very valuable for multiple reasons.
A couple of quick things that I also want to verbalize. According to Mark Stein, Mavericks looking into extending Jalen Brunson. That's a big move.
And Supermax for Luka.
And a Supermax for Luka. But from Luka's camp, he wants to start those negotiations after the Olympics. Now, Trae Young figures to get the same $200 million rookie max contract extension. Luka is also going to get that. So the Mavs are making it happen. The biggest part, just make Luka Doncic happy.
Quick rumor out there right now, Jordan Schultz of ESPN. New info on a few rumors I've been seeing. Spencer Dinwiddie, Norman Powell will not happen to the Mavericks. And then Patty Mills, the rest of that stuff isn't Mavs related. But Dinwiddie and Powell, the Mavs are out on those two guys at this point, which makes some sense. I don't think they have enough money for either of those two guys at this point in time. Unless you trade KP, those guys are probably going to be a little too expensive after what the Mavs have done so far. Speaking of which, grade the Mavericks moves so far in free agency, A, B, C, D, or F. Look, it's not super flashy. I think it's a B, B minus. What they've done is better than what they've done in the past. What they've done in the past, Chase, is let's let our B-level free agents go and try to swing for a miracle A-level player like Kawhi Leonard. That wasn't going to happen. So you bring back Tim, you go sign Reggie Bullock, you bring in a couple of role players like Boban and Sterling Brown as well. Add a couple more players. It's not great, but I think it gives you more depth, and that's about as much as you could have asked for. So A, B, C, D, or F, go ahead and grade the Mavs' moves so far.